Okay, in the last lecture we stopped into this slide, so we saw how to solve the problem and we got the pressure is 43.46 psi, that is less than 50 to 60 psi, recommended 50 to 60 psi, okay? So, now in the second problem is saying, if the pressure at the building is not within the recommended range, 50 to 60 psi, for example in 2.2, we know that we already got it and we got it 43, right? So it's what should be the initial adjusted pressure at the pump to provide the recommended pressure of 56. Now we have to want 56, but we, from the last problem, we have only 43.46 psi. So we have to increase it, right? Show you detailed work. So again, this is the pressure at 1. We don't need that because that's what we are looking, how much we need more. Then P2 is this, calculated from the last page. Right, last problem, and the pressure to be in the faucet at point, that's the one we intend to have. So everything I'm converting into PSF. So then flow rate is this. So finally, pressure required at the point P1 is equal to, I need 56, I already have this, so this minus this plus this, so I mean 87.54, that means 12,606 PSF. Now additional means I have already this total I need, I have available 10,000, so the difference will give me how many PSF I need additional. So that's why this minus this times like say is divided by 62.4 pound per cubic feet. So ultimately this will give me a feet. So I get the head, right? Additional pressure head. So from the head, if I know the power equation equal to gamma QH, okay, or equal to PQ, we can say PQ, okay. So if we can find the pressure from here other than the head, we can just multiply with the Q, we can get it. But here is the gamma is 62.4, Q is 2.5, and H is 28.9. We get 4515 pound feet per second, and 550 pound feet per second is equal to 1 horsepower, I get 8.21 horsepower. So this is my additional pressure, the pump I need, additional horsepower or power pump that I need for to provide the 56 psi pressure into the house at second floor of the house. Now we'll solve this problem. Let's find the total friction loss and velocity of the flow of 200 millimeter diameter GI pipe, galvanized iron pipe, discharging 20 liter per second in a total head of length of 300 meter using Hazen-Williams nomogram. So Hazen-Williams nomogram is the older one. People used to use it. Even he has an equation also, nomogram and equation both. So here are the things given, 20, 200, these are the given, right? So these are the given. Now from the nomogram, so nomogram is 20 and 200. So if I put here, 20 is the liter per second and 200 millimeter is the diameter, I get 2 point. Then if I add the 2 point and extend the line as a straight line, I got here. So HF loss is 3.5 meter per 1000 meter and the velocity is 0.63 meter per second. So that's what I got here. I put those in here. This is the value I got from the graph. Then I calculated this one. Total friction loss in 300 millimeter pipe length is equal to, this is 3.5 per 100,000 meter. So how much would be in 300 meter? So just this divided by 1000 times 300 would be 1.01 meter. This would be my head loss for the 300 meter pipes system using this. Okay, here are the explanation. I have a little bit of explanation here. So in this case, you guys probably, there is a homework problem in that. So homework problem would be like, say you'll be doing either this way and also the other way using the HF, okay? HF means a friction loss because Darcy-Weisbach equation and Hazen-Williams nomogram, and you will compare it. You will see that the Hazen-Williams will give you the higher values, more conservative, but more accurate would be the other one, Darcy-Weisbach equation. Okay, so before we come back here, you can take a look on the topic to overview to see the number of problems. Number of homework problem and solve those and submit those. Here are the graph empty one that you can use. This is the one I would like to show you a little bit. So as I mentioned, F value, right? Friction factor. So if it is not given, how we can find it? So first thing is, if we know the velocity, right? Velocity of the house, I mean the velocity of the flow and other things. And we know the rho, right? And we have to find the mu. Mu is the dynamic viscosity or the absolute viscosity. And gamma is the nu is the kinematic viscosity, right? We know that from fluid mechanics background. We need this data from somewhere. So we'll calculate the Reynolds number, Vd rho over mu, or Vd or dv over nu, right? So it could be velocity times diameter divided by nu. Okay, it's the same thing. Then we can calculate the this one. The roughness is given, so roughness divided by d. Okay, so if we know this one, so for example, I'm here 0.002, I can go this way. Okay, this is the line to follow. Now, if I know my Reynolds number is somewhere around here, I can go this way and I can find the value of f. So this is the value, would be f would be equal to 0.02. This would be 0, like say 0.22, 0.24, then 0.26, 0.28, right? This would be 0.028, 0.028. And so on. That's how we can find it out. I think in fluid mechanics background you have learned it, but if you have don't remember, so this is a kind of review here. And this data can be found from a FE exam handbook with the temperature, if you know the temperature of the water that you are dealing with. Okay, that's it for this topic. I think it's good luck for you.